here already? I swear I'm late for everything.
So everybody asks, you know, what got you into music? And the truth is, my father got me into music. He owned a stereo store growing up, and he loved high fidelity. So when I was a kid, he used to listen to probably the best recorded records of the time, and he would sit there and he would say, "Can you hear the bass? Can you hear the drums? Can you hear the guitars? Listen to that guitar sound. Listen to that piano sound." And he got me listening to the little bits and pieces that made up the songs, you know? So the way I got into songwriting was pretty simple. I picked up a guitar. I realized that I was never going to be Eddie Van Halen. I was never going to be a great guitar player. But every time I played a chord, I heard melodies inside my head. And eventually I started putting words to the melodies. The chords started changing. Before long, I had written my first song. So the best thing about being a songwriter, well, hearing a song that you wrote on the radio, that's the best thing. But the second best thing would be when the check comes. Bada bing. No, but seriously, it's great when a song goes on the radio and becomes a huge hit because you make money, and that's what I do for a living. So to be able to have a hit on the radio that generates income, that in turn allows me to spend my money on my hobby, which is my life, which is the studio. The songwriting process is pretty involved to me. You know, the first thing you have to have, obviously, is an idea. You know, what are you going to write about that day? And to me, all songs come from something that's really happening in your life. It has to be real. If it's not real, I think not only are you not going to feel it as the writer, but the listener's not going to feel it. So normally I'll pick up a guitar and I'll tool around with just a couple of chords, and my brain kind of opens up, I guess, and subconsciously it feeds me an idea, and that idea is just kind of what's going on in my life at the time. So I'll play around with it a little bit, and I'll try to just be as honest as I possibly can with the lyric. And normally I'll start with the verse, and I'll write down the verse, and it's just kind of telling you how I feel, and it's leading someplace. And then sometimes the chorus will just speak to you, it'll just leap out at you, and it'll say, this is what this song is about. Now, if that doesn't happen, then there's a real process. You know, I've got to work, and I've got to sit down, and I've got to say, you know, what is it that I'm feeling exactly? And normally what I'll do is I'll write the last line of the chorus first, because the tagline, that last line of the chorus, is kind of what the whole song is about in most cases. And that, if you don't have that, if you don't have a last line, if you don't have a tag, you don't really have an idea. So once I have that line, then I'll start telling the story in the chorus. So I use Toontrack software basically every day, and I use it on everything I do, because most of the time when it's time to start writing, I have a partner in me, and it's all about speed. So the first thing I'll do is I'll throw Superior up, and I'll get a, you know, I've got a couple of presets. I'll throw a kit up that I like. And the next thing I'll do is, you know, I'll have some guitars ready. And if I start recording some stuff, I'll instantly throw Easy Mix on it, get some really quick sounds. And it's really inspiring when the track comes together and it starts to sound like a song right away. It makes you kind of feel like you're making a record, even though you're only writing a song. And it's pretty much because of Toontrack software that I can get that done fast, and it always sounds pretty inspiring. A lot of aspiring songwriters always email me or come and they ask me, you know, how can I break into the business? And it's a very different business now than when I broke in. And it's changing pretty much all the time. So right now, it's 2011, and I'm not sure when you're going to be watching this, but for right now, the business is all about content. You need to start writing songs, write as many as you possibly can. You need to build yourself a library of songs. And you need, now when I say you need to write good songs, that's very subjective. You need to be able to write a song that when you play it for somebody else, they say, that's great, I could hear Rihanna singing that, or I could hear Avril cutting that song. Or it doesn't even have to be somebody who is picking up outside songs, but in a way where people go, I could hear that on the radio. Then you need to get 10, 15, 20 songs and everybody agrees, these are great songs. You know, you could get a publishing deal, and then that's what you need to shoot for. Go out, take your songs, your 10, 15 songs, go to different publishers, meet with them, play them your best, leave them a CD, let them decide. They're gonna mull it over throughout the company. Does this person have what it takes? And if they do, they're gonna offer you a deal. And it may not be the best deal, because publishing has changed a lot. But it may be a deal that says, I'm going to get you in the room with other great songwriters and other great producers, and you're going to write great songs. And I'm going to take the songs that you submitted, these, I don't know, five or six that I think really could be cut by other artists, and I'm going to start shopping them to other people. And that's really your first and second step to get in the business. Now, obviously, once you get your first cut, everything changes. And then once you get your first hit, everything changes again. But you've got to start writing, and you've got to start recording that stuff, and you've got to be able to give somebody a CD or whatever format and say, here, this is what I do. I'm a songwriter. So as a songwriter, it's natural that you run into times where you can't write and you get what we call writer's block. And when I get writer's block, it can be a terrifying situation because you've got nothing to say. But the truth is that you can walk away. Like some people I know will walk away and go on a vacation and take a couple of weeks off. That's not the way I work. I tend to want to power my way through it. And normally what I'll do is, on my computer I have a list of titles, which aren't really titles, they're more like song ideas and concepts. And I also, I tend to, when I get very, very sad, when I get very, very depressed, I tend to write lyrics, but not really in lyrical form. I write ideas, and line after line after line. Some may rhyme, some may not, but they're just kind of expressing myself in the way that I feel at that moment. And they're not something that I go to all the time. But when those awful moments happen, those writer's block moments, I'll go back to one of these notebooks, and I'll go through it, and I'll look for that one line, you know, that one line that was just a burst of inspiration that night, and I'll find something, and all of a sudden, it's like somebody opened floodgates. And the truth is, the first hit that I ever had was a line on a page. The tag of the song was, she may not be Miss Right, but she'll do for right now. And when I stuck it in the song, I had to do a little bit of chopping just to make it fit. But once I had that, the entire rest of the song was like an avalanche. And it was the same for half that first SR-71 record, Non-Toxic, which was the song that actually got us a record deal. It was just a phrase on a piece of paper, Non-Toxic, and I was like, well, what is that about? It just sounded so cool to me. So my advice to any burgeoning, any young songwriters is every night, even if you don't want to, every night go home and fill up a page of just your ideas and your thoughts. And don't even plan on going back to it, but one day, when you run into that roadblock and you've got nothing to say, start reading back through those ideas, and you will be surprised how fast you can take yourself back to that moment, and the rest of that thought will suddenly come out and be complete, and that is a song. So I hope you guys enjoyed my Toontrack Artist Video of the Month, and I hope I shared some advice that you got something out of, and I'm hoping that you're going to use these products, you know, the Toontrack products, and you're going to just make some great music, and I wish you all the luck in the world.